अस्सलाम वालेकुम, वेलकम क्लास. आई एम योर टीचर मिस उमारा अली. द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ आवर इज़ कंप्यूटर्स. इट इज़ द फर्स्ट लेक्चर. द मेन टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे इज़ द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम एंड द सब टॉपिक्स इज़ क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स बाय अ साइज. Computers are available in different sizes and types. In this chapter, we will discuss the classification of the computers on the basis of their sizes. We will also discuss some not so common input and output devices such as barcode, readers, magnetic ink, characters, reader, braille printers, etc. Okay, there is a classification of a computer by size. On the basis of a size, we can classify computer into five groups. Mobile computers, microcomputers, mini computers, mainframe computers, and supercomputers. Okay, now I'll explain you mobile computers. Mobile computers are the smallest computer designed to be carried around by the user, laptop, ultrabooks, netbooks, tablet, e-books, reader, smartphone, personal data system, that is for the PDAs, and the portable media player, that is for the PMPs. Or all mobile computers. Okay, now we have a microcomputer. They are a small computer that is used by a person at a time. The desktop computer that you see in most of the offices, school, colleges, and homes are microcomputers. Desktop computers are also called personal computers or PCs. We have microcomputers. Microcomputers are the larger than the microcomputers. Typically, mini computers are larger than the microcomputers, typically being the same size as a refrigerator. Mini computers first appeared in the 1960s, and in the 1980s, they got replaced by the microcomputers, which have become smaller and more powerful with the time. Microwax 3100 and HP 2100 are some examples of mini computers. There is a picture also of mini computer. Here we have a mainframe. They are big, powerful, and expensive multi-users computers. They are mainly used for a bulk data processing in large organizations like government offices, airlines, and banks. For example, the IBM 4381, DEC 10, and NEC 610 are the example of mainframes. The last slide, we have a supercomputer. Supercomputers are the biggest and the most powerful computers. They often occupy a whole room. They can process trillions of instructions per second. Government organizations and the large industries use them for the work that required a lot of indirect calculation, such as weather forecasting. IBM's Sequoia and Fujitsu's Gate computers are some examples of supercomputers. Okay, and this is all for today's lecture. Kindly don't forget to check the attachment to complete your task. Have a great day, class. Allah Hafiz.